these nightmares of dragons. I hear their voices.
Dragon Knight Davio, if you have the power.
Hello, today I'm going to discuss about Dota-Dragon split. The season 3 of this series got released yesterday in Netflix. I just thought after the ending of season 2, there won't be a season 3 because it doesn't even make sense, right? I mean, I thought maybe this, and also caution for viewers, this video has a lot of spoilers. I'm going to discuss, I'm just going to give my thought process of what I felt about the series and what felt really good about the series. At the end of season 2, what we see is Shadowblade is sent inside the void and Slyrak vouches to Davian and also Princess Mirana that he'll be able to defeat. He'll be able to defeat Terrorblade and also the entire balance will be restored. But unfortunately, what happens is Slyrak loses the battle against Terrorblade. I don't know what happened exactly because I mean Terrorblade is obviously very powerful and everything. They have actually showed it really well, but still, I still find it hard to believe that Slyrak lost to Terrorblade. That is just my thought. Maybe, I mean, some of you might think he's like much stronger than Slyrak. That is obviously it. But I just think it doesn't even make sense for a dragon to lose to another. I mean, Terrorblade is also technically a dragon. So what I think is, I mean, it doesn't even make sense that he lost and they are. I just thought the series is getting dragged. So I was kind of skeptical about even watching the next few episodes. But I was completely wrong. The series was like really amazing. It was even better than season 2 at some parts. What happens is Davian and Mirana, their characters, their emotions, everything gets collided. And it brings us this holistic feeling which you get after completing a series. Which I'm pretty sure I wouldn't have got in season Season 2 was just, I mean, it was super shallow and everything, the emotions and also the connection, the actual human connection between Davian and Mirana, it doesn't even get explored. And also, Mirana doesn't even manage to like confess to even Davian. I mean, they confess their love and everything, but still, it was just, I mean, childish or something. I don't know, I don't get the exact word, but still, it was not up to that mark. But this season explores everything in a whole new dimension. So what I feel is this book is more of a closure than an extension to the series.
Prayer to a dead goddess cannot save you. Now, for all your power, for the thousand years you've squandered, after all that pain and struggle, we come to the end of your story, but only the beginning of mine.
It wasn't a prayer. It was an invocation.
And also, the one thing which I don't like about the ending is that they are trying to drag the series on and on. Even we see Selimene at the end of the series and I think it was somewhat, I mean, her look was somewhat evil. So what I think is maybe they'll bring in some random shit and maybe make a season 4 out of this series. I'm not sure that, I mean, this is obviously a pretty damn hit series. So I'm pretty sure that, I mean, it is reasonable for them to actually make a series out of it. But still, I don't want it to continue because the ending was like kind of perfect. Series and also the big evil plan gets revealed. We think Invoker is actually a good person, but turns out he's not. I mean, he's a good person, but still he has his own reasons. And what happens, I mean, and also one thing which I felt was the second episode's ending, I mean the fierce battle between Davian and Terrorblade, that should have been the ending of the series. Maybe that is how they could have kept the fans at fans and fans lot more hype, because the ending was kind of okay. I mean, the ending was good, but still, you should have a perfect, I mean, for the fans to love it. Maybe if they would have included that fighting scene at the end, what I thought was maybe the series would have been much more better and also would have had a bigger impact on me after the end.
Souls, to the Menace Moon we pray, crescent light upon us all.
Prayer to a dead goddess cannot save you. Now, for all your power, for the thousand...
But ending was still very traumatic for Mirana, of course, and also for me, because I was kind of attached to her from the start. And yeah, and the other characters, I mean, we get to explore a lot about the Inverker's child. I don't remember her name. What's her name? Fimbren? No, that's someone else. Philomena, yes. Philomena, we get to explore what kind of character Philomena is, and also she's ready to go against her father, the Invoker. And the Invoker is kind of, I mean, he is in the gray area where most of us fallen. So I wouldn't probably blame the Invoker for doing what he actually did. And what I felt was maybe they just went out of topic and everything, and they just made the series out of nothing. I mean, there was actually no plot to even start the series. I mean, even continue the series. But still, okay, fine, I liked it, so I wouldn't complain much about it. And yeah, and another one thing which I wanted to discuss was Lena, the character Lena, the powerful witch who gets defeated at the end of season 2 by Terrorblade. She turns out to be a good character, actually. I don't know what the hell happened wrong in that other world. I mean, the world before this. I know I'm giving a lot of spoilers, but still. I mean, but still, okay, fine, I mean, I don't know what to say. I am not that convinced that the series is, I mean, I'm not that convinced that the season was the best season of all the three, but still, some parts were like even better, and also the premise and the thought process about the destiny and the fate. And yeah, I found this one thing interesting. Mirana goes and meets the Oracle, right? I just thought Oracle looked kind of similar to Terrorblade. I mean, this is, I'm just spitballing around here, but still, this is just my thought. And another one thing which I found interesting was the character Kaden and his backstory. That was actually a good addition to what we already knew. And yeah, pretty much I think that covers it. That is what I thought about this season as a whole. And also I can tell this one thing. Princess Mirana as a character has grown a lot. Also Mene, that is the elf girl Fimbren. So what I think is, even if you take a season 4 out of the series, I will probably watch it, but still, I just felt this series had a perfect conclusion at the end of season 2 itself. I even felt season 2 was like, I mean, kind of draggy and everything. This season has a, I mean, I wouldn't say this season has a lot of fillers, but some scenes were like unnecessary, and I know that happens in almost all the series. That is what I think about the series as a whole. So yeah, thank you for watching this video, and if you like these kind of videos, please give a like button, share it with your friends, and also subscribe to my channel if you want to watch more series like these and also my recommendations. What I think is, maybe for the next video I'll do one about a new series which I am watching right now. I'll come here soon. It's a Korean drama which is also available on Netflix. Yeah, I'll try to do a video about that. Maybe if you're interested, subscribe to the channel, and when I upload that video, you'll get a notification about it. Thank you for watching this video, guys. Signing off from you is Vasu from Techno Explode. Bye-bye.